Hi there, it's Chris Murray from childcare-marketing.com with another weekly success tip. And this week I want to talk to you about something I had a recent epiphany about related to your staff. So the topic of this video is all about staff motivation and appreciation. But the underlying current of it is my aha moment, which is think about all the different kinds of jobs and professions in our society. Think about a typical day in the life of a preschool teacher. Think about, let's say you're working at another kind of restrictive type of environment like a call center. Let's say call center, person that's answering the phone and calling, versus a preschool teacher. Which job has more personal freedom? The preschool teacher or the call center guy? Which one is allowed to get up whenever they want and stretch their legs? Which one can take 5 minutes and go on a bathroom break if they need to without asking? Which one can potentially take a personal phone call for a minute and not have to worry about ratio? Guys, I'm here to tell you that my epiphany was preschool teacher, childcare worker is probably the job in the world that has the least personal freedom. It's crazy. You're in this room with these children. You're not allowed to leave unless you get coverage. You're not allowed to go to the bathroom unless you ask, pretty much. And you also are usually in there with another teacher, a teacher pair, either a lead or an assistant, that you have to get along with every day for 8 hours. And how do you manage conflict if you're that person? I mean, even in a call center, you have different buddies. You can go get a Diet Coke. You can do whatever. You can take a lunch. You can... And so think about that. That was kind of a huge shift for me to think about. So when we wonder why this low-paid job of preschool teacher is a high turnover position, so the average industry turnover year over year for preschool teachers is about 35%. Why? Well, personal freedom is a big deal. Managing conflict. Being thrown into the classroom without the proper training, not given a chance to move up, right? It's a very flat organization, and not being empowered to run your classroom the way that you want to, maybe not being given the tools to do the job. So it's not really about money at the end of the day so much as it's about your feeling as a human being of wanting to make a difference in a way that isn't compelling for you as a teacher, that matters to you, that isn't just driven by some director that wants it the way they want it, or your coworkers, and dealing with all the conflict too of the kids coming in and out. So if you have a lot of part-time kids too, that's a whole issue that I don't have really time to talk about in this video. But all that change management is hard on teachers too. But let's talk about the freedom thing, and let's talk about, so how do we give teachers, what are four ways that we can give teachers a better experience, a better career, a better motivational reason to come to work every day. So the first reason, the first way to do it, I mentioned it, is empowerment. So empowering your employees to manage their classrooms the way they want to manage them. Give them the tools, right? Give them all the stuff that they need and give them the structure that they need and maybe a set of checklists so that you can kind of hold them accountable to how you do things around here in your center. But then let them go. Let them do it. Empower them. Do not micromanage them. They come to you and ask you a question for how you should do something. Put it back on. How would you do it? Let them decide. Okay? So let them manage their own classroom. Give them that empowerment. Second way to really keep them motivated long term is give them opportunities to grow and lead and expand. Even though they might not be able to expand and grow in the organizational chart from lead teacher to assistant director that fast, you can certainly give them opportunities to be a resident expert about a certain topic, be a project leader about a specific project, be a mentor to fellow teachers who are new. So teacher mentors, resident experts, project leaders, all great ways to give them more responsibility. Let them be your social media maven. Let them be a resident expert in curriculum. So many different areas for opportunities to grow, lead, and expand. And then give them compensation for that extra work, okay? Finally, management by walking around. So manage your classrooms every day by walking around the class. I say in the morning between 9 and 9:30, I would do a round if I was the director every day in 5 minutes per classroom. Make sure they have all the tools they need to do their job. Make sure that they are very clear about what they're doing, that they feel supported. Is there anything that you can get them? And if they need some time one-on-one with you, schedule it during nap on the calendar. So now they're set. They know that they might, you know, they'll have some time with you if they need it. That's it. Manage by walking around. I said there were four things. The fourth thing is just the tools to do their job. And I've talked about this in a prior video. It was something like 87% of teachers buy their own supplies for their classroom in this country. Please don't make those teachers buy their own supplies. Please give them all the tools and the supplies they need to do their job. So that's the fourth thing. They're already not paid great. You know that. So don't make them spend some of their paycheck on buying supplies. Come on. Give them what they need. So again, the four ways to try to, you know, address these personal freedoms. And I think also just telling them that you understand this is a challenging job. Gee, I just heard from Chris Murray that you're right. This is the job, one of the jobs in our society that has the least amount of personal freedom. And I want to tell you, Miss Teacher Sarah, that I really appreciate you because, gosh, I can't even imagine how it feels to, you know, have to ask to go to the bathroom and be with Sally all day. And you might not be getting along with Sally and X, Y, and Z and dealing with all these kids and not being able to go on break when you need to, et cetera. The constriction of having to be in ratio in our industry, just it's tough. No other business that I know of has that, you know. Somebody from state walks in, boom, you're shut down. And it's tough, so recognize that. I think just telling your teachers that you recognize it and giving them a big hug would go a long way. But again, empower them, give them chances to grow, lead, and expand, be a mentor, be a resident expert, manage by walking around, and then give them the tools to do their job. So work on those four things. Look at, you know, am I really doing those as a manager and owner? Am I doing those four things consistently? That should help you motivate and retain staff, guys. So that's your homework, is to go think about that and create a plan for doing that better. All right? This has been Chris Murray with Childcare Marketing Solutions with another weekly success tip. And we'll see you next time. Bye.